Embroidery Studio provides a kiosk capability for retail outlets. The kiosk allows simple personalization of standard or custom design layouts. Once configured, a single click from the kiosk is enough to send a design to machine. The benefits for retail staff include minimal training time, customer satisfaction, multi-machine support, productivity, minimal production problems, and easy customization. Set up machine connections. First, set up your machine connections. Machines often require files to be placed in a specific network location or watching folder. In the Connection Manager, set connection type to machine folder. Enter a unique machine name and choose an icon from the drop list to identify it. Select the required file type, for example, PES for brother machines, DST for SWF, and so on. Enter the folder location which has been set up on the network or PC. Designs are saved here in the specified format. If the machine is intended for cap work, tick the Rotate Design option. Repeat as many times as you have machines to connect. New machine connections appear as prominent buttons in the kiosk. Normal kiosk operation. To switch to kiosk mode, go to Window, Kiosk. Select a layout from the Design Chooser. Key in a name. Lettering adjust to fit the allowed space. Change thread color. Click a button to send to machine. A machine file is sent to the specified folder. Create new layouts from old. The simplest approach to customization is to base new design layouts on old. This preserves stitch settings and design scale. Change colors, fonts, and other settings as required. Navigate to the Kiosk Designs folder of your Embroidery Studio installation. Here we choose to edit the caps and hats file. With this layout, lettering is set to stitch from the center out. Before you do anything, save the design under a new name. Edit the stitch area to conform to the target article, in this case 50 by 100 millimeters. Import a design backdrop or clip art. Adjust the fit and place within the frame. Double-click to access object properties. Edit the default text. Adjust line spacing to place a number in the middle of the ball. Select both objects and align horizontal centers. Use Reshape for any final adjustments. Change the default thread color as preferred. The design will appear in the kiosk chooser when you next run it. Add a design backdrop. It's simple to add a backdrop to your design layout. For example, a cap. Select an image from the product visualizer and set a default color. The stitching area will depend on the cap style. The gap between the bottom of the front panel and the design should be 10 to 15 millimeters. Set the object position to 0, as shown. As the lettering object and stitching boundary may not be in the correct position, digitize a start and end point, as shown. Save the file to the Designs folder. Test the new layout. Switch to kiosk mode. The new layout is listed in the Design Chooser. Test your layout by entering text and modifying colors. Note that when using a multi-line layout, the first enter key press will create another line. The next will confirm text entry, as for single line layout.